Si la selección de Estados Unidos alguna vez tuvo un futbolista rockero, ese fue el defensa Alexi Lalas, quien llegó al Mundial del 94 con 24 años.
En 1994, our goal was, as the US team hosting, was don't embarrass ourselves and don't embarrass our country and hopefully do things that help the sport. All of that pressure was on us, and so we wanted to get out of the group. Do something that we had never done before in the modern day.
Hoy, Alexi Lalas es uno de los rostros que uno más relaciona con la selección de las barras y las estrellas. Pero en aquella época, el nacido en la ciudad de Birmingham, estado de Michigan, era un futbolista completamente desconocido.
When I stepped on the field on the first game in 1994 against Switzerland in Detroit, I had never played for a club team. All of my experience was international, which is why when you look at my generation, we all have 100 caps, because all we did for 2 years before the World Cup was travel around the world and play international games. That was my education.
Y si jugar encuentros internacionales fue su educación, su maestro fue el técnico serbio Bora Milutinovic, un entrenador muy exigente, asegura.
There are a lot of players that had difficulty dealing with Bora because he challenged you physically and he challenged you mentally every single day. Not necessarily always about how X's and O's and tactics. That was a huge part. But everything, how you tie your shoes, your surroundings, what you see, what you say, how you act, how you behave, how you look, all of these different things. Bora would challenge you specifically to who you were as a player.
Got my guitars out here, I got my books, I got everything that I need to survive in the world.
El look rockero de Lalas duró poco, ya que antes del arranque del mundial, el técnico le pidió al extrovertido jugador tomar una decisión drástica.
Compared to what it was earlier this year, I was gently asked to cut some hair off, and I carry it around. As you can see, you're getting a real treat here. This is my hair that I was asked to cut off, but.
Si bien hizo feliz a Bora, Lalas seguía pensando que no jugaría el certamen. Al enterarse que sería uno de los defensores centrales titulares, decidió cambiar la pérdida del cabello por un ritual antes de cada partido.
Descríbeme esta foto para mí.
So every player has traditions and rituals, and I'm no different. So that, in that picture, that is in the Rose Bowl, probably before the Columbia game. And I'm wearing a shirt that says Hamilton across the front. Hamilton is a college in New York. My father went to Hamilton. I didn't go to Hamilton, but I had this shirt that I wore before every single game. Superstition, we all know, is in all sports.
El equipo de Lalas hizo historia en aquel mundial, clasificando a octavos de final, algo que marcó un antes y un después en el balompié estadounidense.
I think from a domestic standpoint, we gave our country and the people of our country a pride for something that we don't have a long history in, a history of success. It was okay to, one, love the game. It was also okay to love your national team playing that game. From an international perspective, it was our moment to say we are here, we are part of the game that is played around the world. Yes, it might be different. We might look differently sometimes, whether it's our uniforms, whether it's crazy hair, but we are still kicking the ball and playing the same game that you're playing in your country. And this was our moment to say, hello, we're here, and we're not going anywhere.